We are a community and child well-being site that's partnered with Nebraska Children and Families Foundation. And one of the topics that we talk about is poverty. And we use a great resource known as Bridges Out of Poverty. One of its defining features is how it defines poverty. Mm-hmm. Often when we talk about poverty, we think of just the financial piece, that people don't have enough money. We also think about a particular racial group often. But the truth is that poverty is part of the human condition in general. It doesn't matter what color your skin is. It also is not just about money. So poverty is the extent to which an individual or a family lives without access to resources. Financial is one of those resources, but you also have resources like emotional supports, mental supports, and that means, do we have access to education that's accessible? Are there kids who are falling through the cracks? Can we read? Can we write? Can we compute? It also means, do we have trusting and relatable and sustainable relationships with each other? Do we have people in our lives that when everything falls apart, that we know we can go to talk to them? Or when things are on the edge of falling apart, can we talk to them? Or when there's simply something we don't know, do we feel comfortable enough going and asking someone for help? It also means knowledge of the hidden rules. Every culture, every region has a set of hidden rules. You know, those rules that you don't know you broken them until you get that look. And even the person giving you that look may not know why they're giving you that look. They just know you've broken a rule. Those are the hidden rules, those things that are not written down but are still expected of you. We also need to know or have access to resources like formal register. How we speak at school is not the same way we speak at home. And it may not even be the same way we speak at church or with our friends or even when we go to another state. And knowing those things are important to having a healthy, successful, thriving life that is not in poverty. So someone who lacks financial resources doesn't mean that they also lack spiritual resources. So they could be really wealthy spiritually, but poor financially. But the opposite is true. Someone could be really wealthy financially, but poor spiritually. So poverty is a lack of resources. And that definition, I think, is also really helpful because it includes the entire community.